Hi and welcome to show 2 of PC Engine City. You've just heard a track from Soldier Blade, another top shooter from the guys at Hudson. Can they do no wrong? I've got a top selection on the show today, with tracks from 5 different shoot 'em ups, one platformer and an action RPG. I've also got something a little different for you, so keep listening. Now, PC Engine, aka PC Kid or Bonk in America, was of course one of the most popular series on the engine, and it was only a matter of time before they turned it into a shooter. Not content with the easy route of creating the game on card and then just adding some like fancy music and intros for CD, a different game entirely was produced for each format. While the card version is mostly held as the better one, the CD game, called CD Dengin, naturally has the better soundtrack, as you're about to hear. We'll be right back. Now it's RPG time, and it's Falcom's East 3, Wanderers from East. Much maligned as the ugly duckling of the East family, it broke from the traditional top-down style of RPGs, and it went for a side-on platformer look. It also tried out a technique for multi-layer parallax scrolling, which was used briefly in East 2, but it wasn't particularly successful because it made the whole thing look a bit jerky, which put newcomers off even more. But despite all that, I personally still enjoyed it, and I was glued to it from start to finish, not least because of the fact that it offered another stunning soundtrack. I have to make a note here about the American translation of East 3. Possibly the worst voice acting I've ever heard in a PC Engine game, although I have to say that Dragon Slayer comes pretty close. For example,
think back to your worst nightmare. The feeling of dark isolation and helplessness. The feeling that an evil force controlled your destiny. Perhaps we can compare these emotions with the terror that enclosed the people of Kenai.
Or perhaps not. I mean, honestly, go and squirt some Cynex up there, for God's sake. And not only did it sound bad, they also butchered the translation, changing the very meaning of the opening intro. But regardless of all that, it's still well worth getting. Jumping back into the shmups now, here are a couple of cute little ditties from what is known in English as Long-Nosed Goblin. First is Toshiko, followed by the ending theme World Peace. We'll be right back. you stick Hudson and Red together, you can always guarantee a surefire winner. They followed the success of Gate of Thunder with Winds of Thunder, which put an extra little twist to the traditional shooter. A kind of fantasy theme, you could run around on the ground and engage in close-range combat, which is a bit different from the norm. Had cover art by the top manga artist Masamune Shiro, who's known for things like Appleseed and Dominion Tank Police. The game stretched the engine to the limit again, and had incredible graphics and some beautifully designed bosses. As a side note, there's a nifty little PC conversion in the works at pcenginefx.com, so go and take a look. Now, remember the something different I mentioned earlier? Well, as an on-off feature, I'm going to be playing some PC Engine related remixes done by fans for fans. Remixes can be good, bad, or just plain odd, but at the very least, it's interesting to hear a different interpretation on familiar themes. Today I have for you Superstar Soldier Hardcore Densehead. It's a remix by DJ Pretzel, and it's available to download over at Overclocked Remix. That's ocremix.org, so do go and check it out. It's a great site with some really decent tunes on. I'm going to end today with one of the earlier and best CD-based games. Wonder Boy Monster Lair was a stunning conversion, far better than the sucky Mega Drive version, and a great straightforward arcade game to play. As usual, Hudson did top work on the music arrangements, making this another of those games that's worth buying just as an audio CD. So until next time, happy gaming.
Okay. What the bomb?